The big problem we've had is understanding the economics of the shale business. It's a different kind of business than the traditional conventional oil. And a lot of the wildcatters who have been very successful early on really didn't have the capital strength to maintain their operations. So they ended up borrowing too much money. And when you live based on the banks, that's not a good way to run a business, frankly. And so from a consumer standpoint, I think we're in good shape for a fairly stable oil price. Supply is going to be strong. There's a lot of drilled but uncompleted wells out there, which could bring more oil to bear if they're needed. And I think that the problem is going to be oil price for a sustained period of time, because the Permian and the Bakken and so forth, it just takes more oil price to make a go of it.
I definitely want to dig into the price specifically and what you think the sweet spot would be, but the S&P energy sector overall, it's up a mere 5.5% over the past decade, despite all the disruption, despite all the technological advances in terms of fracking and U.S. shale coming online. Do you think, going back to the fact that debt is such a key part of this, that there is a reckoning coming for U.S. producers?
Yes, I do think that there will be a significant amount of M&A, or call it rationalization, or call it cost reduction, whatever it will be. It'll take multiple forms and faces. But the industry is very good over time at getting its costs in line with its profitability, in line with its financials. So I would not write this industry off, I'll tell you. The technology is getting better, but here's a hole in the formula. The hole in the formula right now is natural gas, and the inability, because of lack of physical infrastructure, to move the natural gas to markets. And so they're flaring an enormous amount of natural gas, which is not monetizing a valuable natural resource. And so that's a little bit of a hole in the bucket that is draining strength from the industry. So we really need the physical infrastructure to come together to move that natural gas to markets. It will happen. It will come. It's just taking longer than most people would like.
John, could another hole in that formula be pressure from climate change? It's hard to see how this sector continues to attract the amount of capital given pressure from governments for the banks that are funding these projects.
Yes, that's a good point. And from a political standpoint, there's a bullseye on the fossil fuel industry for sure, especially on the part of the Democratic Party. And until, you know, they may have some success politically, until the price rises to where consumers say, I don't want to pay that much. Let's have more oil and natural gas available. But here's something to watch. And I think 2020 will be a big year for this. The industry, particularly at the leadership level of the integrated majors, are really getting their act together when it comes to the carbon management technologies of the future. And whether it's capturing CO2, whether it's reusing CO2, whether it is somehow producing less CO2, I think the decade, the next 10 years, are going to be a dramatic turnaround in how the industry itself, not the government, because the government can't do anything really other than say no to things, but the industry will figure out how to manage that CO2 issue, and I think it will position itself on a much more sustainable footing for the decade ahead.